Hello, this is Bern, and on this number one of five videos, I'm going to be sharing with you seven hidden blockages that are preventing you from finding the deep, lasting love that you want. Stick with me. Hello, this is Bern, and welcome to your greatlifetv.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women like you how you can create an amazing relationship and attract the kind of quality man you want as a direct result of stepping into the most alive and feminine version of you without the need to play games or do any type of manipulation or gimmicks. Now, on today's episode, which is part number one of a five video training series that I'm creating for you, I'm going to be talking about how to identify before you start calling in the one, before you get better skills into dating and relationships. I want you to find out what are some of the things you might be subconsciously doing, these hidden blockages that are preventing deep love from entering your life, who are things that are making your love life not move forward. And when it's not moving forward, it's actually moving backwards, which is an interesting principle in life. Things that are not progressing are actually going down. So the first step that I have for you right now, the first blockage that you might not be realizing right now is your energy. By energy, I mean the way you show up into the world, your level of connection to yourself, your level of passion for life, your level of aliveness, the sparkle in your eye, the way you move, the way you breathe, the way you connect, your disposition towards life. That vibration and energy, your aliveness, if it's not where it needs to be, if your feminine energy is not where it needs to be, if your level of openness of heart is not where it needs to be, then what happens? You're going to take lots of actions without producing the result that you want. And in your mind, you're doing the right things. You're doing the right things, but you're doing it from a place energetically that is not going to get you what you want. Imagine right now that you put a paper bag into your face, but you took a long time to make that beautiful face precious. You maybe put a mask the night before and you did your makeup the way you want to and you're smiling really big and you put a paper bag in your head and then you go out into, I don't know, a club or you go into a restaurant where there's lots of high quality men. If you have a paper bag in your head, they are not going to resonate with you. And that's exactly and precisely what you're doing when you're going out into the world from an energetic place of meh, M-E-H, right? When you're doing that, when there's not enough life and when there's not enough of you to resonate, then you can do the work, but the work is not gonna work for you. Number two hidden blockage is where maybe you say, well, Bern, I'm doing the right things. I have a lot of energy. I'm super excited. I'm type A personality and I show up and I ask questions. And yeah, sometimes the problem is not that you have low energy and that you're not showing up with enough intensity, aliveness, spark, and excitement, but that the excess excitement or anxiety is turning guys off. Why? Because there is a balance between showing up energetically and filling up this uncomfortable space and silence with noise. I'm talking about when your excitement is such that doesn't allow you to step back. When your excitement and aliveness is one that doesn't allow your vulnerable heart to show up because it's always happy and always full of movement and there's never enough pause where the guy can actually say, now let me step in, let me move forward, let me miss her a little bit, let me feel drawn to filling that void with something. When you are overcompensating for your maybe insecurity or you're overcompensating for your lack of vulnerability by just doing things and showing up super excited without giving the guy the space to see your heart, that will also cause you to take lots of action and not get the result that you want, or in both cases, attract the wrong type of man that you don't want into your life. Number three is the beliefs you have, beliefs about who you are, beliefs about men, beliefs about relationship, beliefs about the world. Why? Because when your beliefs are such that men are maybe out to get you for the most part, and you think that all guys are like that, then when good guys come up, you're gonna be judging them by the same set of lenses. And it's not gonna get you the results you want. Or maybe the belief is that my city is full of guys who are unavailable. Well, all cities have unavailable and available guys, but as long as you believe that your city is the special place on earth where guys are unavailable, then you no longer have to put yourself out there. You can see all guys through that filter, and then again, get pain and pain and pain back to back. If your belief is that you're not beautiful enough, or sexy enough, or tall enough, or old enough, or young enough, all those beliefs will impact drastically the way you show up, the way you connect with men, your level of confidence, your level of being able to hold your ground, your ability to step into and ask for what you want. All those things are going to be mediated by the beliefs that you have. So it's incredibly important that you, if nothing else, write down on a piece of paper all the beliefs you have right now about men, about relationships, about dating, and look at the ones that might be stopping you from getting what you want. And even if you think, well, this is the truth about life, circle them out and perhaps question them a little bit longer, because if you fall into the wrong belief, that could hold you back years. Just one simple belief that is strongly attached to your psyche and it's unquestioned will cause you not to get what you want. Number three, sometimes you have an addiction to the honeymoon high. I call a honeymoon high when you connect with a guy and it feels exciting, and then the excitement in some way tapers down, and instead of going deeper and figuring out what it really takes both of you, then you move on to the next thing, and it's exciting again for 2 or 3 weeks, maybe a month, and then fizzles down, and then you go for the next thing. It's like you're searching. It's not just you, guys do the same thing, right? If you're searching for that instant high, and the moment it gets serious or not fun or just silent, you feel like the excitement is roughed off and you need something different. That's part of the reason why so many human beings right now don't create deep lasting relationships, because they are unable to hold their ground and the silence and figure out what it really takes to go deeper versus just get excited and get that instant heroin rush of highness, metaphorically speaking, of connecting with someone and feeling validated, feeling chemistry, feeling passion, but not really knowing that he was one. The next one is not asking powerful questions. Not asking powerful questions early on is devastatingly. When you, at the beginning of the dating dynamic, don't take the time to ask good questions, you are going to inevitably get more emotionally connected, invest more time, invest more energy, and then get the deeper you go with someone without knowing the truth, the harder and the more shocking the heartbreak when you realize that the guy that you're connecting with is very different from what your expectations are. And not only that, but that you could really figure that thing out earlier, you just chose not to go there because you felt afraid of scaring the dude. So asking powerful questions early is very important. Next one, which is number six, is an attachment to the wrong guy due to lack of sexual boundaries. So let's say you know what you want in terms of love, and you connect with someone, and that human being has a strong sense of chemistry with you. You have a strong feeling of passion with him, and you decide to go all the way, and you have sex with him, and you connect physically, and then all the things that you have on your list of things that you want will get a little fuzzy. And you might even translate them incorrectly, where you might think that the things that you want are this guy because it feels so good to be with him, that you'll start distorting the truth in order to continue feeling that level of connection and passion with him. So what happens when you take longer to connect physically, when you take a lot longer to have sex with him? That you'll be able to be far more objective and remove yourself from the situation where the man that you're with is not good, versus continue connecting, seeking that emotional validation, and then when it's too late, because many things have happened, you've been emotionally hurt, he's betrayed you multiple times, or you've betrayed him, because like it's not a good fit at that level, then you break it off. And when you break it off at that level, you've gone through more pain, more heartache, it's harder to go into the next relationship, it's hard to let go of him, so you're just pushing love away. This is one of the strongest hidden blockages that takes place. And it's not easy to solve, but it's simple to solve. It's just waiting longer to have that physical level of connection with someone. Number six, having a sprint versus an ultra marathon mindset. It's similar to what I was talking about before, but it's more specific to, you think that stories have told you, books have told you, Cinderella saw the guy and like first love at first sight, right? So you think that love should happen really quickly and that you should just know. I mean, grandma told you, when I saw grandpa, I just knew. I just knew he would be my husband. So you buy into this series of bullshits. I mean, not that it's not true for some people. It's true for some people, but for most people, it's not true. For most people, it takes longer. So when you have this mindset of it has to happen soon, you should instantly know. If you don't feel butterflies in your stomach the first time you cross eyes and it's just not your guy, when you have that mindset of a sprint versus an ultra marathon, then you continuously seek the wrong partner and let go of amazing human beings that, given more time, more energy, a bigger investment in connection, would have yielded exponentially higher returns in terms of something sustainable, passionate, and loving, that would have just taken more time, like a flame versus a firecracker, to be able to shed some light. Hope this is helpful and insightful to you. As I said, this is part one of five. I'm going to be releasing the next few videos, and I'll be linking them at the end, and all the videos will be linked so that you'll be able to have it. But right now, if you feel this is helpful to you, I'm going to ask you to do three things. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel, click the little bell, and that way you'll be notified when the next few episodes like this one come out, the next four more on this five-part series. Number three, if you want to go deeper, there's a link on the description of this video, the first link that allows you to sign up for a free masterclass I created for you. And click on that link, enter your name and email, and you'll be immediately redirected to access that masterclass that is free. If you want my help, handholding, accountability, second link on the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. Thank you so much for connecting, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.